This is the operation video for the John Deere HD200 and HD300 SelectSpray series, which are available with the John Deere ProGator. We will show you how to operate the SelectSpray series correctly and safely. We'll provide setup and adjustment information, as well as maintenance information to keep your SelectSpray unit running in good condition. But first, a few words about safety. Remember, you are responsible for your own safety and the safety of those around you. Safety should be the first thing you think of when operating any machine on the golf course. Always wear your seatbelt when driving the ProGator or any equipment that has a rollover protection structure. Always make sure the ProGator is parked safely with the brake engaged before working on or around the sprayer. Always handle and mix chemicals safely, and be sure to wear the proper personal protection equipment. For information on handling chemicals and personal protective equipment, refer to the operator's manual. Always wear the proper personal protective equipment, or PPE, when operating the ProGator and spraying chemicals on the golf course. Again, see the operator's manual for more information. Since we won't cover everything in this video you need to know, be sure to read the printed operator's manual for both the ProGator and the SelectSpray series for additional safety and machine operation information. The operator manuals are available in Spanish as well as other languages. Please contact your distributor if other languages are needed. This video also contains a Spanish version. Here's a look at the different features and options available for the HD200 and HD300 SelectSpray. The John Deere SelectSpray series offers you choices. The HD200 has a 200-gallon spray tank, while the HD300 has a 300-gallon tank. Both models are available with a choice of either a manual controller or an automatic rate controller. And there's a choice of either a centrifugal pump or a diaphragm pump. Triple nozzle bodies come standard, as well as the throttling valves. And both models feature an electro-hydraulic lift lower system for lifting and lowering the booms. SelectSpray options include a clean load chemical eductor for easy mixing of chemicals, and a foam marker system to help the operator apply chemical with consistent overlapping. In this section, we will cover how to install the sprayer using the optional storage stands. Roll the tank using the optional storage stand and position it into place over the ProGator frame. Line up the rear pivots of the sprayer frame over the rear mounting points of the ProGator frame. Rotate the handle to lower the rear jack wheels until the mounting holes align. Then install the pivot pins and secure them in place with the quick lock pins. Connect the lift cylinder to the sprayer by aligning the hole in the lift cylinder rod end with the hole in the frame, and install the connecting pin and secure the flat washer and spring locking pin. Rotate the handle on the rear jacks so that the jack wheels are no longer in contact with the ground. Remove the pin securing the jacks and remove the jacks. Then connect the rear wiring harness and the hydraulic hoses. Start the ProGator. Pull back on the lift lower lever until the front storage wheels are no longer on the ground. Remove the pins and remove the storage legs. Push forward on the lift lower lever to lower the sprayer onto the ProGator frame, and secure the sprayer to the frame with the mounting clamps. Route the wiring harness through the clamps by the operator controls. Secure the controller to the ProGator dash using the wave washer and pin, and you're ready to go. In this section, we'll show you how to use the manual rate controller. With this controller, you can manually control your spraying operation parameters. Always stay focused on your surroundings and watch for bystanders when operating the controller on the golf course. On the upper row, left to right, is the foam marker switch, the left boom wing lift lower switch, the right boom wing lift lower switch, and the pressure gauge. Below the pressure gauge is the pressure control switch, and three switches used to initiate flow to the right, center, and left booms. Just left of the individual boom switches is the boom master switch, which controls flow to all three booms. The controls have a logical design for ease of use. When the foam marker switch is in the center position, no marker foam is released. To release foam from the right foamer head, flip the switch to the right. Flip the switch all the way to the left to release foam from the left foamer head. Flip the left boom wing switch down to lower the left boom, and flip it up to raise the boom. Flip the right boom wing switch down to lower the right boom, and flip the switch up to raise the right boom. The pressure gauge displays the sprayer operating pressure so you can monitor sprayer performance. If you see any change in pressure while operating and you are operating at a constant engine RPM, this indicates that there is a system fault that you should check out. The pressure control switch controls the fluid pressure that is delivered to the nozzles. Push the switch up to increase pressure and down to decrease pressure. The master boom switch controls flow to the three boom sections. Push the master switch up to send fluid to the booms and down to stop flow to the booms. The right, center, and left boom switches let you send flow to each boom individually. To use these switches, push the master switch to the up position. Then push the right switch up to send flow to the right boom, the center switch up to send flow to the center boom, and the left switch up to send flow to the left boom. Push the switches down to stop flow to the booms. In this section, we'll show you the location of the automatic rate controls and how to use them. With the automatic rate controller, you can pre-program precise spraying operation parameters. On the left side of the auto rate controller are the auto manual control key, the digital display screen, the pressure control keys, and the foam marker switch. Below the foam marker switch is the right boom wing lift lower switch and left boom wing lift lower switch. Next to those are the right, center, and left boom section switches and the boom master switch. Push the auto manual control key to choose either automatic control or manual control of your spraying operation. In the automatic operating mode, the controller automatically maintains a uniform application rate, even when there are changes in the operating conditions, such as faster or slower ground speed. In the manual mode, you can increase or decrease your rate manually to suit your application requirements. The digital display screen shows you the actual values seen by the controller while spraying, including operating pressure, flow rate, ground speed, and nozzle type. Use these values to monitor your application as you spray. Use the pressure control keys to change your nozzle pressure when spraying in manual mode, or to change application rates while spraying in automatic mode. Push the plus key to increase the pressure or rate, and push the minus key to decrease pressure or rate. When the foam marker switch is in the center position, no marker foam is released. To release foam from the right foamer head, flip the switch to the right. Flip the switch all the way to the left to release foam from the left foamer head. To lift and lower the boom arms, flip the left boom wing switch down to lower the left boom, and flip it up to raise the boom. Flip the right boom wing switch down to lower the right boom, and flip the switch up to raise the right boom. The master boom switch controls flow to the three boom sections. Push the master switch up to send flow to the booms and down to stop flow. The right, center, and left boom switches let you send flow to each boom arm individually. To use these switches, push the master switch to the up position. Then push the right switch up to send flow to the right boom, the center switch up to send flow to the center boom, and the left switch up to send flow to the left boom. Push the switches down to stop flow to the booms. Now we'll show you the automatic rate controller features and how to use them. To power up the auto rate controller, simply press the Pro key once. The screen will display the software version and serial number for a few seconds before the controller enters the operating mode. To power the controller down, turn the master boom switch off. Then press and release the pro and minus keys. The controller will store the latest application rate and then power down. The area volume feature measures both the application area and the total volume you applied. The area counter measurements are based on the values you program in for the number of tips per boom and the tip spacing. The volume counter depends on the flow meter pulses. A readout on the lower right area of the display screen will alternate between the two measurements every 3 seconds. The area counter shows the total area applied, while the volume counter shows the total volume applied. To clear the counter volume measure, set the master boom switch to the off position and press and hold the auto manual key for 3 seconds. The controller will display a message asking you if the field counter should be cleared. Use the plus or minus keys to select yes or no, then press the pro key to save the change and return to normal operation. The tank volume feature counts down the volume of chemical remaining in the sprayer and alerts you when the tank level is low. You program the maximum tank volume and low volume indicator levels in the system setup mode. To reset the tank volume, make sure the master switch is off. Then press and hold the plus minus keys at the same time to display the tank volume remaining, which will appear and begin flashing. Then use the plus key to change the amount of liquid that's now in the tank after refilling. When done, press the pro button to save your change. Repeat this process whenever you add liquid to the tank. The boost rate feature lets you boost the target rate up or down in 10% increments. To boost the target rate, make sure the system is operating and the master switch is on. Then, use the plus key to boost the target rate. The rate will increase by 10% every time you press the plus key. The screen will display the amount the application rate is boosted for 2 seconds. The target symbol flashes whenever you are in boost mode. To return to your original target rate, press the minus switch to return in 10% increments. You can also press and hold the plus minus key simultaneously with the master switch on to immediately return to your original target rate. To lower the target rate, follow the same steps, only push the minus key to lower your application rate in 10% increments. The SelectSpray automatic rate controller also provides sensor alarms to alert you when the controller is unable to achieve the programmed target rate. The application alarm tells you that the target application rate and the actual application rate are different. If the controller senses a discrepancy, you'll hear 3 short beeps to indicate a high priority. And the application rate window will flash to warn you that there's a problem with the sprayer plumbing, operation, or programming. The no speed alarm only occurs when the master boom switch is on. If the controller stops receiving pulses from the speed sensor, you'll hear a steady beep indicating medium priority. The no flow alarm only occurs when the master boom switch is on. An alarm sounds when you activate this feature. If the controller stops receiving pulses from the flow meter, a steady beep will sound indicating medium priority, and the turbine symbol will flash. The no pressure alarm only occurs when the master boom switch is on. If the controller senses that the pressure transducer has failed or lost its connection, a steady beep alarm will sound, indicating medium priority. The low tank alarm only occurs when the master boom switch is on. When the volume of liquid in the tank reaches the low point, as set in the system setup mode, the tank volume symbol flashes on the display screen. In this section, we'll cover how to program the SelectSpray automatic rate controller for your application. First, press the Pro key in the upper left-hand corner twice to exit the operating screen and enter the application setup screen. On the application setup screen, you will see the application rate number flashing. A flashing number tells you that you can change its value. To do that, use the plus or minus buttons on the right side of the console to change the application rate up or down in 1/10 increments. Note that the default setting for application is U.S. gallons per acre. You can also reconfigure the controller to read in other units of measure, including U.S. gallons per 1,000 square feet, imperial gallons per acre, liters per meter squared, and liters per hectare by using the plus and minus buttons in the system setup mode. See the operator manual for more on changing settings in the system setup mode. For this example, we will set the application rate to 80 gallons per acre and then press the Pro button once to save the new application rate. When you change the application rate, you probably noticed that the pressure also changed. The rest of the application setup mode helps you calculate the pressure, speed, and nozzle size needed to achieve your chosen application rate. However, the controller does not store these values. The values only serve as a guide to tell you what pressure, speed, and nozzle you will need to use to achieve your rate. If you speed up or slow down within the given range of the nozzle, the controller automatically compensates for it. To see how the pressure, speed, and nozzle type affect the controller's ability to achieve the target application rate, do the following. First, change the pressure to let the controller calculate what ground speed is needed to achieve your application rate for your given nozzle and pressure. Change the ground speed to let the controller calculate what pressure is needed to achieve your desired application rate for a given nozzle and speed. Or, change the nozzle type to determine what pressure is needed to achieve the application rate for a given speed. To see how changes in pressure affect the target rate of 80 gallons per acre, press Pro and use the plus and minus buttons to change to a more desirable value, such as 35 PSI. You can adjust the value in 1 PSI increments. Notice the speed also changes as you adjust PSI. The controller is telling you that to achieve your target rate, you must slow down and spray at a lower pressure or speed up and spray at a higher pressure. To see how changes in ground speed affect your ability to achieve the target rate, press the Pro key until you see the machine ground speed number flashing. Then use the plus and minus keys to adjust to a more desirable speed, in this example 3 miles per hour. As you do this, you'll see that the pressure changes as well. The controller is telling you that more pressure is needed to achieve your application rate with an increase in ground speed, and less pressure is needed at decreased ground speed. If you are not satisfied with the speed or pressure you must spray at to achieve the rate, you can change the nozzle type. To do this, press the Pro key again until the nozzle selector arrow begins flashing. To change the nozzle type, push the plus or minus keys to select a nozzle that sprays at a more desirable pressure for the speed that you want to spray. Once you've selected the desired nozzle, press the Pro key again to go back to the application rate. You will see the application rate begin to flash, which means you can adjust the rate if needed. You now need to store the application rate to get ready to spray. Press and hold the Pro button for 2 to 3 seconds. When the settings are stored, the screen will revert back to the operating screen. In the operating mode, pressure and speed will read 0 as the controller is now displaying the actual readings. Remember, the controller does not store the speed and pressure, only the nozzle and application rate. Once you begin spraying, you will see the actual pressure and speed in the display. In this section, we will cover spray tip operation and selection. There are many types of nozzles and tips available through the John Deere Spraymaster program. The standard triple nozzle bodies give you a choice of 3 spray tips. The flood style spray tips, which are wide angle, flat nozzle tips, are used for broadcast spraying. The ultra low drift style spray tips are wide angle, flat fan type nozzles with dual air eduction that provide a uniform pattern for broadcast spraying. The flat fan style spray tips provide a fan-shaped spray pattern that is finely tapered at each end. The tapered ends allow offset overlap of the spray pattern for more uniform coverage. Simply rotate the nozzle body until the spray tip you want to use is in the activated or down position. Before operating the sprayer, you'll need to know how to adjust the throttling valves and system pressure. To adjust the throttling valves, turn all three knobs clockwise until they are fully turned in. If you have an automatic rate control box, set it to manual control. Then, with the PTO engaged, turn all three of the boom switches on, as well as the master boom switch. Set the system to your desired spraying pressure, which is normally between 30 and 50 PSI for most turf applications. Be sure to note the operating spray pressure that is indicated, and then turn off the right boom section. The pressure will change when the section is turned off. Back at the throttling valves, adjust the right throttle valve until the display indicates the pressure that was set on the control box earlier. At the control box, turn the right boom back on and turn off the center section. Back at the throttling valve, adjust the center valve until the display indicates the pressure that was set on the control box earlier. Then, at the control box, turn the center boom back on and turn off the left section. And back at the throttling valve, adjust the left valve to the pressure that was set on the control box. Then, turn the left section back on. To check the adjustments, turn off any of the boom sections. If adjusted correctly, the pressure will remain the same on the control screen, no matter which boom or combination of booms is turned off. Now we'll show you how to operate the SelectSpray on the golf course. When operating the SelectSpray, always wear the proper personal protective equipment when filling the sprayer tank. This includes full cover clothing, eye protection, and rubber gloves. Read the container label thoroughly and open, pour, and mix chemicals in a well-ventilated area and dispose of chemical properly. See the operator's manual for more information on PPE and handling chemicals properly. First, with the ProGator park safely. Turn the three-way valve at the rear of the tank so it points toward the tank. Fill the sprayer tank half full with water using the quick connect coupler. Be sure to clean the fill area before connecting the hose to avoid contaminating the spray mix. You can also fill the tank through the lid. Close the inline strainer valve by turning the knob counterclockwise. Rotate the triple nozzle body to your selected spray tip and adjust the boom height to match the spray tip angle using the chart found in the owner's manual. With the park brake locked, start the engine. Engage the PTO and set the throttle to full. If you are running a diaphragm pump, turn the throttling valves all the way in. Turn off the agitator by turning the yellow knob clockwise all the way in. Turn the green knob on the pressure relief valve to set the relief pressure at 200 PSI. Then reset the throttle to your desired level. And turn the yellow knob on the agitator valve counterclockwise to adjust the tank agitation as needed. If you have the auto rate control box, program your application rate as covered earlier. Make note of the recommended operating pressure for the application rate and nozzle displayed by the controller. Then, set the automatic rate control box to manual control and turn the desired boom selection switches to on. Then, turn the master boom switch to on. Then, adjust the system pressure. Adjust the throttling valves and turn the master boom switch off. Load your chemical into the tank manually or by using the optional eductor. Then, fill the tank to your desired level. On the golf course, set the automatic rate control box to auto. Establish and maintain the proper ground speed and turn the control box master boom switch on. When you finish spraying, you will need to drain and rinse the spray tank. First, dilute any excess chemical in the tank with water and apply it to an area that was previously treated. Never dump excess chemical into storm drains or near any body of water. To rinse the tank, park the ProGator safely on a surface that cannot be damaged by chemicals. Again, do not park near storm drains or any body of water. Rinse the interior of the tank as needed. Then, place a container under the drain hose at the rear of the sprayer and remove the hose from the retaining cradle. Open the valve by turning the yellow handle to align with the hose, and allow the rinse water to completely drain. When the tank is empty, turn the valve 90 degrees so it is perpendicular to the hose. Then, secure the hose on the cradle and properly dispose of the rinse water. The SelectSpray units also feature other attachments for easy and convenient use. Be sure you are wearing the correct personal protective equipment before doing any of these procedures. You can use the clean load eductor to load chemicals quickly and easily at a lower loading height. To use the eductor, rotate and remove the transport lock pin. Then, pull the latch toward the hopper to lower the platform into the loading position. To load the hopper, open the eductor lid to check for foreign objects, which hinder performance or contaminate the sprayer system. Then load the hopper with chemical. When the hopper is loaded, close and lock the lid by turning the cover clockwise. Turn the inlet valve handle to divert the pump flow into the inlet line, and open the hopper valve handle by rotating it downward to the vertical position. To use the foam marker, first prepare the solution in the foam marker tank. Lower the right and left boom wings. With the key in the on position, move the control box foam marker switch to either the left or right position as needed. Foam should output from the foam nozzle on the side selected with the switch. Adjust the rate by rotating the dial on the foamer back to increase or decrease the output. The convenient optional support stands make the SelectSpray series easy to remove and store, and allows you to use the ProGator for other chores. Before removing the sprayer, make sure the tank is empty, then park the vehicle safely. Start by disconnecting the wiring harness and the spray pump hydraulic lines. Then remove the automatic rate controller by removing the pin and wave washer, and relocate the controller to the rear storage position and secure it using the washer and pin. Remove the bottom lock nut and bolt to allow the frame clamp to pivot open from the frame. Do the same on the other side of the sprayer. Pivot the clamps upward and secure them in position using the bolts and lock nuts. Be sure the tank is empty before raising the lift cylinder. Start the engine and use the lift cylinder control to extend the cylinder rod approximately 25 to 30 centimeters or 10 to 12 inches to gain access to the lift cylinder connecting pin. Stop the engine. Make sure the brake is set and remove the key. Then install the front support stands and secure them using the quick lock pin. Press down on the lift lower lever to lower the sprayer so the front support stands of the sprayer rest on level ground. Install the rear jack stands and secure with provided pins. Rotate the handle to lower the jack wheel onto level ground on both sides of the sprayer. Keep rotating the handle until the pressure is relieved on the rear pivot pins that secure the sprayer to the ProGator. Remove the quick lock pins and pivot pins at the rear of the ProGator. At the lift cylinder, remove the spring locking pins, washer, and connecting pin at the rod end. Rotate the jack handle evenly on each side to raise the sprayer assembly until the sprayer completely clears the mounting points in the ProGator frame. Make sure to raise the sprayer high enough to clear the drain hose at the bottom of the tank. Slowly drive the ProGator away from the sprayer assembly. Install the pivot pins at the rear of the ProGator for storage. Install the pin and hardware to the lift cylinder for storage. Then route the excess wiring harness under the frame tube and back toward the front of the frame, and secure it away from moving parts with tie straps. Regular maintenance will keep your SelectSpray sprayer in top operating condition. Before each use, check and clean the inline strainer. Check and clean the suction strainer if equipped. Check the hydraulic fluid levels. Check the sprayer tank for damage. And check inside the tank for debris. And check all connections for leaks. Also, Check the oil level in the diaphragm pump if equipped. After each use, drain and rinse the tank, boom lines, nozzles, and hose reel if equipped. As needed, adjust the boom wing flexible joint spring tension, bleed the controller pressure gauge and/or isolator. Once a year, lubricate the boom wing pivot points. If you have a diaphragm pump, replace the diaphragms and change the oil. And inspect and clean using compressed air or replace the nozzles. The HD200 and HD300 SelectSpray series from John Deere Golf. The innovative sprayer system that lets you maintain turf health with maximum efficiency. For more information on the SelectSpray series, see your operator's manual or contact your nearest John Deere Golf distributor.